Welcome to Rashi, Parasha Study, Parashat Vayakhel, Pekude. This week we're going to take a look at two comments of Rashi and see how he manages to bring out life lessons, important lessons about Judaism, through seemingly minor details in the description of the creation of the Mishkan. Our first detail starts, Rashi makes a comment, an observation about who's building the Mishkan. So we have Bezalel ben Uri ben Hur l'mate Yehuda. He's the main builder of the Mishkan, the son, grandson of Hur. Hur is the son of Aharon, Rashi comments, to the tribe of Yehuda. But his assistant is Ito, together with him, is Aholiab ben Ahisamach l'mate Dan. And Rashi automatically right away points out the following. Mishivit Dan. Aholiab is from the tribe of Dan. What does that mean? What's the implication? Min hayirudin sheba shevatim. B'nei shefachot. Dan is one of the b'nei shefachot. He's not a child of Leah. He's not a child of Rachel. He's definitely not a prominent shevet. He's more yirudin sheba shevatim, more the simpler shevatim. But yet, when Hashem is choosing someone to build a Mishkan, he chooses Bezalel and the Holy Av together. Hishvuhu hamakom l'svalel l'mlechet bitu. Hashem made him equal to Bezalel to build his house. Even though Bezalel is from the tribe of Yehuda, lekayim mashneimad onikad shoa lifneidal, that Hashem does not distinguish, does not recognize the poor person in the front of the rich person in front of the poor person, maasiyah dav kulam, all Hashem's creations. Now, obviously, here Rashi is pointing it out not just for us to know that Hashem is fulfilling what is described about him in Sefer Yov, that he's not going to discriminate between people where they come from, but obviously to point it out to us, if this is Hashem's value, we have to follow Hashem's values as well, and make sure we don't discriminate based on our own assumptions about who's important and who's not important enough, and instead realize that everybody is God's creations, and that automatically makes them important. So it doesn't matter Dan, Yehuda, or anything like that, everybody's going to be important. That's the first value that she manages to teach us through focusing on the minor detail. The second detail is describing the creation of the kiyor. The kiyor was a bronze made out of copper, or not bronze, nehoshet, made out of copper, a wash basin outside of the Mishkan where the Kohanim would have to wash their hands before coming to serve in the Mishkan. It says that they were created, the copper was gathered from marot hatsoveot asher saveu pitach ul bu'id. And meaning these mirrors that these people would gather around to, these mirrors, soveot from the word savat, to gather around. And that was the mirrors that they were given, that were made out of copper, nehoshet, and they were taken and melted down into create the kiyor. So Rashi comments, and he says like this: Benot Yisrael hayu beyadan marot sheraot behem kishen kashitot. They had these mirrors, the wives of Am Yisrael, and they had these mirrors in order to dress up, make themselves look pretty. Afutan lo azul lehavil lechet haMishkan divato. Okay, so they brought them as to donate to the Mishkan, the material, the copper, very nice, and they're happy to bring them. But here's where it gets interesting. Moshe says, wait a minute, I don't want to accept these mirrors. These mirrors are used for women to beautify themselves. And that could attract the Yetzirah on people. Is this a good thing? Is this something that I want to have? Knowing that, something focusing on physical beauty. Accept them. They're more precious to me than anything else. This is how they created Soveot, an army of Jewish people in Egypt. And Hashem saying, yes, the mirrors are used for women to adorn themselves to look beautiful. That's not a bad thing if they're making themselves look beautiful for their husbands. And it brings in the Midrash, the husband would come home from the Avodat Perech, terrible labor working in Egypt, and they don't want to reproduce. The husbands don't want to reproduce physically. They're tired, but also, what are they bringing a child into this world for? What purpose? Came the women, ומלכות להם אכל ושניהם מאכילות אותם ונוטלות המראות, כל אחד ואחד רואה עצמה עם בעלה במראה, במראה, she takes the mirror, she shows her and the husband, they look at each other, and by making themselves getting together acquainted in a light way, therefore they aroused their husbands in order to continue Am Yisrael, and therefore Rashi brings a pasuk tahat ha-tapuach orarticha, this idea of the daughters of Am Yisrael ensuring the continuity of Am Yisrael, but Am Yisrael might not be interested in having children, and the females understood, no, it's important to continue Am Yisrael to have that hope. They had the hope that the men might have not have had, and therefore they ensured the continuity of Am Yisrael through using these mirrors, and therefore Hashem said, definitely accept them. And then Rashi comments, and he goes further, the kiyor is going to make peace in the future between man and his wife, in order to use as the mesota waters to prove to a husband who's suspicious of his wife that his wife is innocent of wrongdoing, and therefore recreate that relationship as well. So we're learning something very interesting. Here's something a Jewish value Moshe might have not intuited right away, that there's a value to beauty. It could be something positive if used the right way. And this idea of Bishut Nashim Sidkaniyot Nigalua Utenabim Mitzrayim, the faith that they had, the continuity of Am Yisrael constantly, despite all odds, despite the situation, is something that is always important. Continuing Hashem will ultimately redeem us. The faith that the women had were imbued in these mirrors that they brought to the Mishkan. So here we have a couple of nice ideas of Rashi, Jewish values, through this details of the creation of the Mishkan. Shabbat Shalom.